Oh, happy day. The lighting has been returned to its normal crappy... last night, if you were watching the show, first of all, I'm sorry. But last night, the lighting went out, and we had to do the show by... We had special emergency lights, and we used Jeff's eyes, and that's all we had. And so I'm on the Tweety today. I'm on the, you know, the Tweety. And I'm checking my stream. On my Tweety. And I'm taking my, and there's like, there's a bunch of people, most people were very kind, I have to say, but there's a bunch of people like, yeah, well, if the lights weren't out, how come the cameras are working and the robot worked? And I'm like, I don't...
Ay, caramba!
No! If I knew how it worked, I would have fixed it! And then it's like, because people are like, oh, you're just doing that for comedy. You're like, are you mad? Are you mad? Why on earth would I do that? Because it wasn't the first time it's happened. I suppose I punched a hole in the ceiling when it rained as well. That was me, was it? These are the same people that are on my Tweety stream that say, oh, Craig, you're dyeing your hair. I don't dye my hair. Here's what happens. Sometimes, Einstein, when you put gel in your hair, it looks shinier and darker. Google it.
What's that coming to go?
One must always remain charming. I don't dye my hair. I haven't had a facelift. I didn't put a hole in the ceiling. And I didn't pretend that the electricity wasn't working. All of these things are the way they are because they are that way. Sometimes I dye my pubes.
Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Progressive. Visit progressive.com today. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Quietly, we don't want the noise and the vibration of your genuine applause to blow the lights out again. Sit down, everyone, sit down, relax. It's gonna be fine, everything's gonna be just fine. I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm gonna hurt you a little bit. Safety words, banana. Ready to have a little fun? Safety word. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, indeed it is. It's a great day for President Obama. His health care was upheld by the Supreme Court. The president apparently had three speeches ready to go this morning. One if the law was overturned, one if the law was upheld, and one if Joe Biden chewed up the other two.
I like trains.
president is very cocky now, the president. He released a statement today. He said, you know who this healthcare doesn't help? Osama bin Laden. And then he added, yeah, I was born in Kenya, so what? The media went crazy today. It went nuts. And all the different media outlets, of course, have their own point of view. The MSNBC or the lefties, they're like going, yay! And Fox News or all the conservatives, and they're like... And Bravo was like, one more day till Magic Mike opens. You know that some people watching CNN were so shocked, they started rioting. I'm kidding. I'm kidding, no one watches CNN. They got rid of Larry King. What the hell is wrong with you, CNN? Yeah, let's get rid of Larry King. The only thing I watch on CNN! Except, of course, for Wolf Blitzer, who's... Yeah, that's it, I think. You know, one thing's for sure, now that the healthcare is guaranteed, I'm frying everything I eat. I'm doing it, man. That's me, fried food and cigarettes. I'm gonna get cigarettes, I'm gonna deep fry cigarettes. I'm gonna deep fry cigarettes, I'm gonna smoke it, and I'm gonna go, ah, get in all the goodness. I know what you're thinking, Craig, where do you exactly stand on this thing? Wherever you stand, baby. The Supreme Court. I'm sorry, I've had a lot of fried cigarettes today. The Supreme Court justices made the ruling this morning, and then immediately they went on vacation for the summer. I'm like, what the hell? That, you know what that's like? That's like passing gas and then leaving the room. It's like waiting until it's your floor in the elevator and then just... You know what happens with that? I'm always the guy standing in the elevator and the smell's there and it's not my smell, and then the doors open and the very attractive lady walks in. And I'm like... Safety words, banana. Anyway, now that this law has been upheld by the Supreme Court, there's only one place left for it to go, and then it's Judge Judy, and then that's it. Of you are asking, Craig, come on now, what does the Supreme Court ruling mean? How does it affect me? I need answers. Well, you are so watching the wrong show. Now, if you want to watch someone distill the debate down to jokes about my penis, then welcome home. You know, I know it's really important. I know, and I'm reading about it today, and I'm really trying my very best to read about it. And I'm not a stupid man. A little bit stupid. Not that stupid. Like, I've read books. I've written books. I'm telling you, I can read, but I'm reading about this stuff, and it goes, I start reading, and then it goes, and then it's Charlie Brown's teacher. I can't do it. I can't, man. I know it's important. It's like, read, very important. And then Google Kardashian. That's what I... I actually did find something today that wasn't this. I'm Googling because I'm like, I can't talk about this, although apparently I've been talking about it for 6 minutes, but I can't... Well, I was going to talk about something else, I thought, by the time people get to this show, if they're still awake, they've sat through about 6 hours of middle-aged white guys on TV going... Bah, bah, bah. And some going, yeah! And other ones going, yeah! And you go, oh, God, please, can we get to the farty foreign guy with the penis jokes? And here I am, talking about it again. Do you have any feelings on this thing, the big healthcare law? I mean, it doesn't affect you much, you being dead and such. That's Charlie Brown's teacher.
Yeah. Banana.
We haven't done anything.
anything that's even remotely dangerous.
Yes, you have, Daddy.
What are you doing?
Stop the ride. I want to get off.
No. Do you know what I was thinking, though? I was thinking it's time we got you some new clothes.
Yeah, I'd make some new duds.
We're going to the new studio. I want you in three-piece suits.
So I can look like you.
Yes! Three-piece suits. Did I spit there? I did a little bit. How weird is it? You can't light the show unless it's like boogers or spit. Like, you can't light the thing, but the minute I do something like that, or then it's like it glistens in the air. Some kind of well-lit, high-budget movie, and everything else looks like crap.
Body fluids equal comedy gold.
It's true. I think people get upset, though, if you do too much in the way of body fluid comedy.
And how the hell have we stayed on the air this long?
Well, here's the thing. You can disgust some people all of the time. And you can disgust all the people some of the time. That's all I got. What do you think?
Banana.
All right, then, do the thing.
All right.
From the CBS basement in beautiful downtown Doucheville, you're still watching The Late Late Show.
Right, there's a commercial break, and then somebody from the, probably the warm-up comedian, just before you come back, shouts, "Applause!" to the audience, and they clap for their damn life. I think, look, we've been through a lot together on this show. We've been through my facelift, my hair dying, we've been through my, what else, the time I screwed the lighting up, when I made it rain through a hole in the ceiling, Anyway, here's what I'm saying. I don't think we need to do that anymore. I think that's for the late night guys that have got an actual show. I think what we should do is let's try it again. Let's imagine there's been a commercial break and nobody's shouting applause at you. And here's what we're gonna do. We're going back and it's gonna be like this. What do you think, Jeff? Okay. Well, that felt deconstructionist there, didn't it?
It felt like
we
did.
Yeah, I do. I think we had a little go at the genre there, a little bit of sedition.
Took a little jab, a little
Did
jab.
A little jab, yeah, yeah. Just add a little poke. This is from Veronica. Oh, Veronica in inverted commas. Okay. Veronica. why would you put your name in inverted commas? Well, Veronica, in Seattle, Washington. You ever been there?
Oh, I've been there.
Oh, you like it there, don't
I'd
you?
I like it there.
Dear Craig and GP, lately my husband's away a lot for work. Is that your husband? My husband's been away a lot for work. It's hard on him. Oh, I'm sorry. It's hard on him, but I love the time apart. Am I a bad wife? No, Veronica. No, it's all right to enjoy your own company, isn't it, Jeff?
Sure, I do it all the time.
I
right
do
over
too.
Here.
I do too. Sometimes I enjoy my company two or three times a day. Nothing wrong with it. Come on, it's the 21st century. Right, Jeff?
Right this very moment, I'm doing it.
You're what? You're enjoying your own company?
I'm prodding my stream.
No, checking your stream.
No, I'm prodding.
This is from Mike in Miami, Florida. Mike sent a picture of himself. There he is. He's a peacock. Hi, Craig and Jeff. I totally geezed out there for a minute, didn't I? I was like...
I like salty food. I think I just crapped my pants.
Yeah. Anyway, hi, Craig and Jeff. I have my first DJ gig this weekend. I'm still looking for a stage name. Any suggestions? Well, what do the people say when we walk in at the club again? Or it's, oh, it's...
Here comes a player!
So you could call yourself, Oz. This is from Barry in Rosslyn, New York. You ever been there?
Ooh, yeah, Barry, yeah.
Oh, you've been to Barry?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Hi, Craig and Jeff. We're excited to see you and Jeff at Radio City Music Hall this fall. That's true. We are going there, aren't we?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I'm going to be doing the thing. You're just going to make an appearance. All right, I've changed my mind. We're both going to be doing stuff.
We're going to be checking our streams? What are we doing?
It's a long way off. We'll figure it out round. When are we there? October the 6th.
Sure.
So we'll figure it out October the 6th.
Hide your bitches.
Cause
here come the players.
We're excited to see you and Jeff at Radio City this fall. What can we do to get you to notice us in the audience? Well, remember this. If I notice you, so does security. Perhaps you just sit back and allow us to take care of you. And remember that the safety word is banana. All right. Oh, right, a minute to do all of these. All right, we're doing them quickly. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
We'll do a speed read.
Let's do it. Here we go.
Okay, thank you. This is from Charlotte, San Antonio, Texas.
Yeah, right, it's great. Right.
Hi, Greg, Jeff, and Secretariat. Oh, horse. All right. People say that some foods before bed give you bad dreams. What food affects your dreams? Cheese, Jeff.
I couldn't understand a word.
Okay. Banana. This is from Rob in Boston, Massachusetts. Dear Craig and Jeff, I don't really care about fashion, but my husband wants me to update my look. Do I need to change my style to please him? No, but you don't do it some bitch well. I'm just calling it, girls. I'm just calling it. I mean, no disrespect. I'm just telling you the truth. You know it's true. This is from Diana in Albuquerque, New Mexico. You ever been there?
Oh, yeah, a little bit. All right, guys. Great, yeah.
Hi, Craig and Jeff. With the hot weather, I'm really enjoying gazpacho. What's your stance on cold soups? I'm against them. Jeff?
I like putting them in my pants.
And finally, this is from Sam in Pittsburgh, PA. He says, hi, Craig and Jeff. My friends still use my old college nickname, even around my kids. How can I tell them that I've grown up? I don't know. What is your old college nickname? Tank? What was your college nickname?
Cold Soup Pants.
I never had a college nickname. I was a high school dropout. So what I was called at the age when people are getting called college nicknames, I was getting called the accused. Yeah, you like that, don't you? We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. My first guest tonight is in The Amazing Spider-Man.
Ooh.
It's in theaters July the 3rd. Take a look at this. Please welcome Denis Leary, everybody. Denis Leary.
Hey.
There you are.
I almost got a bigger round of applause as I faked like I was leaving.
Well, they got excited. They were like, yes!
No, it was kind of depressing.
No, they thought you were being controversial. They like that.
I think they're disappointed because all you said was, my next guest is in The Amazing Spider-Man. You showed the clip. I think they thought Andrew Garfield was coming out. Am I right?
Whoa, wait. First of all, let me speak for America because the movie isn't out yet. So let me speak for America when I say, who the crack is Andrew Garfield?
Hey! Now, wait a minute.
Now, wait. All I'm saying is, after the movie, it'll be different. The whole world will know. But on July the 4th, the whole world will know this kid's name. He'll be a giant movie star. But right now, it's Denis Leary, man. It's Denis Leary.
I might as well enjoy the last moment.
The last moment.
Of Denis Leary getting a bigger round of applause from this audience than Andrew Garfield will.
Well, that's right.
For the rest of his life.
Well, here's the thing.
The kid is going to be a huge star. He's a great actor.
Yeah.
And he's a good-looking kid. And he's 26. And he's going to be around for the next 30 years. And let's face it, you know, my days are numbered.
No, you'll be fine. Do you have a thing for this kid? What's going on?
Why does everything have to come back to having a thing and some kind of homoeroticism with you?
It's me, man. It's my thing.
You know, wait, you're right. I kind of do have a thing.
Well, you know, he's pretty cute.
I got to tell you the honest truth.
Yeah.
You know, we shot for a while. We did a lot of acting scenes with my family. He's dating my daughter and everything. Mm. So we had been doing that for a couple of weeks, and we'd been in rehearsal. So I had not seen Andrew in the Spider-Man suit. And I pride myself on being a man that really, you know, the only thing that catches my eye when I'm looking at another person really is, you know, a woman.
Yeah, yeah.
But I got to say, the first night we shot some action scenes and he walked in the...
Did you have to say banana? Uh-oh.
But... I had a weird moment when he was walking by. It was me and him doing this big scene, and he walked in front of me, and he turned around, and I was like, I'm staring at Spider-Man's ass. What am I doing?
That's all right,
What am I doing? What's wrong with me?
Come on. It's fine. Listen up.
It was a little speed bump.
Yeah, it's fine.
And I got over it.
No, you'll be fine. Yeah. It's all right. Yeah. It's like that time. Do you ever see in The Simpsons when Homer imagines Flanders in a ski suit?
Yes, yeah.
And he's like stupid, sexy Flanders. He's all like turned on.
Yeah.
That's what happened to you in the Spider-Man
thing. That's all that happened.
Yeah.
That was the only time I looked at his ass in the Spider-Man suit. Well, I shouldn't have said that. That made it sound like
Just let it go, man.
Let it go. It never happened. Can you cut that out of the interview?
Sure, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Right.
Hey, what's going on?
I saw several of your shows from Scotland, and I have to say, let's face the facts. You guys like them. I love them. You are a strange and damaged individual.
Oh, yeah. No doubt. I'm not claiming not to be. So are you, though.
And so am I.
Yeah.
And it's one of the reasons that you and I hit it off when we first met 30 years ago, whenever the hell it was. 20
years
ago.
Yeah, that's right. Remember that?
My son's 22 now, so it was 22 years ago.
Yeah, that's right.
My son was born that summer.
That's right.
So, but I watched that Scottish show, and I forget which nights it was, but there were so many bizarre things in there that I was like, first of all, I can't believe that they pay you to do this on a nightly basis. Second of all, there were bits in there, man, that were so strangely done. I mean, there were musical numbers and stuff where I was like, this is like abstract comedy. Like, I can't believe this is on television.
Mm-hmm.
And it was great. I loved it. It was fantastic. And I was kind of jealous because I wasn't there.
Well, come to the next one.
I will definitely.
We're definitely going to do another one. Not in Scotland, though. We were done there. We're moving on.
Okay.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Plus, if I go back now, they might have something to say.
Yeah. There was some great stuff there.
Yeah. Do you ever go back to the old neighborhood?
Which old neighbor?
Where
Ireland?
You grew up.
Yes, I do.
You ever go to Ireland? Do you ever go back to Ireland?
Yeah, I go back quite a bit. I haven't been in a while now, but I used to go quite a bit when the kids were small, especially so they'd get to know their Irish cousins. And my whole family, my mother and my father, were born on adjoining farms, which is now basically one big farm. So my parents were both from Killarney.
Right.
And of my 7 million Irish relatives, they all live in Killarney. I was with my cousin Mahal once and my cousin Timo, and we went up to the bar in a pub at a hotel in downtown Killarney.
Downtown Killarney. Like, uptown Killarney, downtown Killarney.
Right. And there's a beautiful girl, raven-haired Colleen, behind the bar. She's about 10 feet away, and she's waiting on somebody else. And my cousin Mahal goes, oh, look at her. And he's single at the time. He goes, I'm going to ask her out. And she turned around and said, no, you're not. I'm your second cousin. Hey, meanwhile, it's legal to marry your second cousin in Ireland now. So you can missed the boat.
You can marry your first cousin.
Where?
Scotland.
What did that? Is that a recent rule change?
I just made it up, but it might be true. Listen, it might be true. I think it's true.
Can we be honest about the two countries of our origin?
Right.
Okay. Ireland and Scotland.
Well, most of my family, to be honest, are from Ireland.
Okay.
Right.
So that. Yeah, that's my theory about, you know, basically Scotland and England. Anybody who's not English, who has an Irish name or a Scottish name in England, is from Ireland. Listen.
Yes.
There were, in the beginning, in the time of the Druids, there were literally eight people, four guys and four chicks. So we are all descended from the same family.
Yep.
Yep. And we've been each other for years.
That's why I don't want you to get too twigged out about this Spider-Man thing that happened.
Because Andrew Garfield is probably Irish. He's British, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
He's probably my cousin.
Whoa, wait. He's British?
Well, he was born here, then raised in Britain.
Whoa, wait. So he doesn't talk like Spider-Man when he's not being Spider-Man? He talks like Downton Abbey, sort of like that, when he's not being Spider-Man?
Yeah, it's like Hugh Laurie being Dr. House.
Yeah, I find that rather disconcerting.
I don't. I like it. I kind of like it.
So you like guys to wear Spider-Man outfits and talk in English accents, do you? That's what you like.
Listen. There's a better way to
put that. Because I'll do it, man, because you're okay. Cute. I know that's what I'm saying.
There's a better way to put that.
All
it's
right.
Just that I'm attracted to the same type of man that Emma Stone is, apparently.
Oh, yeah. She's an attractive young woman.
Oh, my God.
You play her dad?
I play her dad.
That's
God,
horrible,
she is absolutely... Yeah. Let me tell you something. Mm-hmm. I don't care why you might think about going to Spider-Man. Don't go to see me, because I am, truthfully, in 3D, I am a horror show, okay? Second of all, I don't care if you go because of Andrew Garfield, but you should go to see this movie in 3D because Emma Stone is beautiful,
yes.
And in 3D, it's...
It's like she's in the room.
It's like she's in the room, yeah. and she's looking at you.
Whoa.
Well, not you, because if she looked at you, I don't know what kind of reaction she would
have. Why the hell would you say that?
Listen.
It's like, oh, we're talking about a little bit of fun, and then suddenly, lingonberry.
No, that wasn't.
Strudel.
Okay.
No,
that wasn't.
Uh-oh.
Listen, I think you're in the same category as me. We'd probably have to ask our wives, but I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Because I know it to be true.
What?
When you walk into a room, it's probably much the same sometimes when I walk into a room and there's a pretty girl and you say hello. A lot of girls go,
yeah.
They get scared.
Because I still think I'm cute.
Yeah, well, yeah, exactly, right?
Yeah.
And on top of which, we're scary monsters anyway.
Yeah.
We're not the nice guys. We're the dangerous, crazy guys.
I know.
Come in, hey, how you doing? What's going on? Are you single?
Yeah.
It's scary.
Yeah, no, it's
I can't believe my wife married me, to be honest.
Well... I am very grateful in the lapse of judging my own wife. But I don't know. I do that, though. When I'm talking to young women, I sometimes have to remember. I'm 50 years old now, you know, and I'm a creepy man. Yeah.
And I know. That's my point, is that we were both creepy when we were 20.
Yeah.
That's the thing. It's not like we got less creepy.
No, that's it.
You know?
We stayed creepy. We just now look as creepy as we were.
Yeah. Now we look like... We look like our grandfathers trying to pick up young girls.
No, you know what we look like?
Oh, and your wife's younger, right?
Yeah. You know, it's funny, because my wife's younger than me, and I was really worried about it. I love her. It's my wife.
Yes.
But I was really
and
worried.
And she knew who you were when she met you?
Nah.
She knew the fake you.
Yeah. But the thing is...
She knew the TV Craig Ferguson.
Oh, that's the same one.
No. That's a little cleaned up, ladies and gentlemen, just to be honest with you. The TV Craig Ferguson may seem incredibly crazy.
Cheeky monkeys.
Yeah. Think about how crazy he is in real life.
No. But here's the thing. I was very worried about it because I was thought, people are going to say mean things because my wife's younger than me. And they did. Some people did say mean things. And then I thought, wait, I didn't let the church tell me how to live. I didn't let my parents tell me how to live, my school, the society I grew up in. But I was going to let ooh la la pop culture tell me how to live.
No, not a chance.
So I relaxed.
Yeah, not a chance. No, because you're like me. Unfortunately, we have the same genetic, because we're cousins from the same age.
Yes, we are.
To this day, and I'm a grown man with my own children. When somebody tells me, like when the nuns used to say, whatever you do, don't open that door. First thing I'm doing
is open the door. You gotta open the door.
You know? Don't light a match in here, whatever you do. Where's the matches? I mean, that's... That's me.
Yep,
that's me.
Me too.
You know, it's always going to be me.
That's why he's screaming for a commercial break, and I just can't do it.
Like 3 minutes over,
are we? Don't do it, Craig. Don't do it.
I gotta do it, man.
Crikey. You see, to tell you.
Do it, do it, do it, do it, do it now. I got up. Time to talk. I gotta get him out of here.
I gotta mention my song.
Oh yeah. What song's going on? You do it.
I have a new song called Kiss My Ass.
Oh, I saw that on the Tweety.
Yeah.
Kiss My Ass.
Yeah, it's called Kiss My Ass. It comes out the same day as the movie. Actually, it comes out Monday. And there's a video that the Funny or Die people did of the song, which comes out Monday as well. And it's a kind of a alternative national anthem. I love the national anthem, but, you know, it's
Kiss My Ass is a national anthem?
Well, look, can I finish? I love the
national... 51's Banana.
I love the national anthem. It's a hard song to sing.
Yes,
and
it is.
And it's not that funny. But Kiss My Ass is catchy,
pretty
and
funny.
It's danceable, and it's pretty funny. So it's for the 4th of July when you're partying and you want to just kind of get going. It's a song
Kiss
called
My
Kiss
Ass.
My Ass. Yeah.
Do we have any, do you have a clip of the Kiss
Do
My
you really?
Ass? Oh, you did?
Kiss my ass.
That's nice.
I'm American.
I love that.
Care of gas. It's 11 bucks or more. Crazy world. It's a ticking time bomb. Any day could be the last.
Next guest is an extremely talented and beautiful singer-songwriter. She's on tour now performing Raise Hell off her new album Bear Creek. Please welcome the amazing Brandi Carlile, everybody. Brandi Carlile.
I've been down with a broken heart since the day I learned to speak. The devil gave me a crooked start when he gave me crooked feet. But Gabriel then came to me and kissed me in my sleep. And I'll be singing like an angel until I'm 6 feet. Bigger men have died. I'm gonna raise hell. There's a dug a hole inside my heart to put you in your grave. At this point, it was you or me, and mama didn't raise no slave. You took my face in both your hands and looked me in the eye, and I went down with such a force that in your grave I lie. I'm gonna
Godspeed, Mr. Tibbles. Now, Jeff, between you and me.
Yeah.
You know, like, some nights I think some of the outfits that Tien and Lisa wear are great.
Oh, man, smoking hot, man.
Right. But I can't help but feel tonight they kind of phoned it in a little bit. You know what I mean?
I see what you mean, yeah.
Yeah. It's like, what do you want to do tonight, Tien? Well, it'd be super great if we just put on pink jackets, and that would be enough. Am I right? Are you even awake? It's just you and me tonight, pal.
Just you and me.
Just you and me.
Suit Pants Peterson and the Accused.
Good night, everybody.